Hello and welcome. Today we're doing a question from LeetCode. It's called Search Suggestions System. It's a medium. We're going to jump right into it. So you're given an array of strings, products, and a string search word. Design a system that suggests at most three product names from products after each character of search word is typed. Suggested products should have common prefix with search word. If there are more than three products with a common prefix, return the three lexicographically minimum products. This just means the three earliest when it's sorted alphabetically. And we want to return a list of lists of the suggested products after each character of search word is typed. So this is going to be similar to an autocomplete. We're going to type a character at a time, and we want the three smallest alphabetically sorted words that it could match to. So example one, we have the following products: mobile mouse, money pot, monitor, and mouse pad. And we are going to be typing out the word mouse character by character. So once we type out that first M, what is our output going to be? It's whatever smallest alphabetically sorted. So actually, let's go ahead and sort this input over here. So this input of mobile, mouse, money pot, monitor, and mouse pad, once sorted, becomes mobile. This is M-O-B, then M-O-N-E, followed by M-O-N-I, then M-O-U, M-O-U-S-E, right? This mouse, and then it's followed by mouse pad. So this is sorted alphabetically, and we are looking for the word mouse. So going character by character, when we go in M first, we're going to return these three. So it's going to be mobile, money pot, and monitor. Then once we have MO, it's still actually going to be mobile, money pot, and monitor. Then for MOU, the only two that are relevant that match the prefix are mouse and mouse pad. So we only output that. And when we have MOSE, it's going to be the same thing, right? All the way up until mouse, we're just going to output mouse and mouse pad. So this is our output over here. It's a list of lists. Now, example two, we have the products just Havana, and we're also searching for Havana. So no matter what we type, this is the only list of strings that we are going to output Havana itself. And say we weren't searching for Havana, instead we were searching for banana. As soon as we type out our first B, nothing is going to match. So just going to be an empty list for every single character. So the output for all of banana will be a list of lists that's all empty. And we have some constraints over here. All the strings of our products are unique. They're all lowercase English letters, and we have limits on the actual lengths. Okay, how are we going to solve this? Now, if you've seen a problem like this before, a search suggestion system, an autocomplete, anything where we want to find a prefix matched to a bigger word, we know we want to use a prefix tree or a try data structure. If you don't know what that is, if you're not familiar with it, I'm going to link a video we've done previously on this channel below. Definitely go check that out before. We're basically building up from that logic. The idea is we have a tree data structure. This is similar to, say, a binary tree with left and right nodes. But instead of having left and right nodes, we're actually just building characters every single time. So we're going to start with M. M is going to have a child of O, then B, then I, then LE, all the way down. So actually, to see an example of this, say we have the following input. Say for our input example, we have the following words. We have mobile, mouse, M-O-U-T, mouse, and mouse, M-O-U-Z. These are our products. And we're going to have some search word that we are going to type out character by character. And we want to return the three max lexicographically minimum products that would correspond to whatever prefix we're typing out. Now, in order to do that, we need to know which words in our products list will actually correspond to every single prefix. And they do need to be ordered alphabetically. So step one would actually be to sort our input products. And over here, it's already sorted, right? We have MOB, MOUS, then MOUT, and MOUZ. Now, what we want to do is just build out our prefix tree. In order to do that, we will start out with some empty current root. And to it, we're going to add the very first character of the first product that we're coming across. So we have M over here. Now, what we can do is at M, store the word mobile. We know our list, we went ahead and sorted it. So mobile will be the smallest product for M. This will be one of the three words that we return should we type out M. So we can actually store mobile and some separate list that corresponds to this object that we're defining over here for M. Now M's child is going to be the next character, which is O. So O is going to be a child of M. Now M is going to have two things, right? It's going to have a list. This is going to keep track of the three smallest product words for this character. And it's going to have a children dictionary to keep track of any other character that might be typed out after M. So in that dictionary, we're adding a key object of O. And now that we have M and O, what is the word that would correspond to MO? That would still be mobile, right? This was sorted alphabetically. So if we don't have a word for a character yet, whatever word we're trying to add to our tree will be part of that list for that character. So mobile will also be part of MO. So if we were to type out MO, mobile would be one of the first words that we return in our list. Now, what's the next character? That's B. So we're also going to add B as a child to O with mobile for B as well. And just going down the path, right, we're also going to add an I. So if we were to type out MOBI, we would still have mobile as one of the products to return. Then we would add an L with mobile and finally E with mobile as well. So if we were to type out M or MO, MOB or anything down this tree, one of the words we're going to return is mobile. Now we want to add in mouse, this next word in our products list. So we're starting at the top and we see that M's already there, so we don't need to define it. Instead, since we haven't hit this length of 3 in our list, we can go ahead and add mouse to the list for M. So now if we were to type out M, we would output both mobile and mouse. Now mouse's next character is O, which we still have in this tree. There's a path for it. So we're just going to append mouse to this list over here. The next character is a U. Now, this doesn't exist in this dictionary for MO, so we're going to go ahead and add it in. So another child of MO is going to be U, and its first word is going to be mouse. Mobile doesn't fit here, right? This is now MOU, but mouse does. So we're adding this as a list. And just going down the path, filling the rest of this out, it's going to be S, followed by E. And these are all just going to have the list with mouse. Now, if we were to do the same thing for MOUT, we see that M's already defined, so we can just add MOUT over here, and we've now hit the max 3 we need for M. Now there's also an O in mout, so we're going to add that in over here. There's also a U, so now U is going to get an additional word, which is going to be MOUT. If we were to type out MOU, we would output a list of mouse and mout. Now there isn't an S in MOUT, so we need to add another child of T to this path of MOU. So we can go ahead and add a T over here, and its first word will be MOUT. Now, just adding this last word super quickly, we have M-O-U-Z. We see that we have an M defined, but we've already hit this length of 3, so we're not going to bother adding an M-O-U-Z, right? It's not going to be the lexicographically minimum product to return. So we're just going to go down this path. We have M-O-U-Z. Again, this is filled out. Then we have M-O-U. This is not filled out, so we can add M-O-U-Z over here. Now, for this last character, it's M-O-U-Z. Z is not defined, so we're just going to go ahead and add it in. So if we were to type out M-O-U-Z, we would just return a list with only M-O-U-Z as that word. And this is all we really need to do. The first thing is going to be sort our input, then go ahead and add every single word to our try data structure. We're going to be adding in a character at a time. Each character object is going to have a list corresponding to the first 3 alphabetically smallest words to output, as well as a children dictionary to keep track of all the other characters that would flow down below it. So let's go ahead and code this up. Okay, to code this up, we know we want to create a try node, so we're going to create a new class for that. So it's going to be class of try node, and it's going to have a def in it with self, and we're going to have 2 fields in this node. It's going to be self.children, which is going to be a dictionary, and it's going to be self.products. This is going to be our list that's going to be capped at 3 for the 3 words that would correspond to wherever we are in our tree right now. We also want to initialize our structure, so we are going to have another def in it with self, and we are going to say self.root equals a try node. So now that we have this sort of defined, we can go in our actual function. We know we are given a list of products. We want to sort that alphabetically. So products.sort, this is going to sort it alphabetically. Now we want to loop through all the products in product, so all the words in there. So for word in products, we want to add it to our try root. So for that, we're going to create a helper. So we can just call self.addWord. Now let's create a function called add. So to define this helper function add, let's write it over here, self, and it's going to take in a word. Now for this word that we are adding, we know we want to add it character by character to our structure, and it's going to start off with this root over here. So let's say current is self.root that we defined up here. Now we just want to loop through all the characters in our word. So for character in word, we want to see if the character already exists in our children's dictionary for current. Current is this root. it's children's dictionaries here. For example, if we were adding M-O-U-Z, we see that M already exists in here, so we don't need to explicitly add it in. But if we were adding in the word cat, C doesn't exist in here, so we do need to create that. So if that is the case, if character not in current.children, we need to go ahead and create it. So current.children of current will be its own try node. So say we are starting over with another example. This is the word that we are passing in to add. It's going to be cat. We have current being this self.root that we defined up here. So it's going to be a try node, which means it has its own children and a list of products that's going to start off being empty. Now we are looping through every single character and word. We start off at C. We make a check. If character not in current.children, current.children is this dictionary. C is not in here. To current.children, this should be character. Okay, to current.children, we are going to be adding in this character that we are on and creating its own try node. So we're adding C over here, and it's going to have its own try node, which means it's going to have its own children and its own products. So C is going to have its own product list, as well as its own dictionary for its own child nodes. Now that this is created, we want to move current down to this new node that we just added. So current is going to equal current.children of character. So now current points to this C object, and we want to check C's product list. If it is less than the length of 3, we want to add the word we are on. So if current.product, the length of this, is less than 3, current.product.append our word. And this is the case, right? This list has a size of 0, there's nothing in it. So to it, we're going to add in cat. Once this is done, we go back in our for loop, we move on to the next character. We have an A, so we make another check, right? If character not in current.children, remember we moved current to be C. So now we're going to check C's child dictionary. A does not exist in here, so we're going to go ahead and create it. So we're adding in to current children, this dictionary, we're adding in the character we are on, which is A, and it's going to be its own try node, which means it's going to have its own product list and its own children's dictionary. Now we move current down to be current.children of this character that we are on. So current is now going to move down to A, and length of current.product is less than 3. So we're adding our word to products. And if we go back in this for loop, right, the next character we are on is going to be T. We do the same thing again. We see the character is not in current.children. So we go ahead and add it in. Current.children of T is going to equal its own try node. So we have an empty list and an empty dictionary. And if you notice, right, if this was already in current.children, we don't need to create it. Instead, we would simply just move to it. So we would still be moving down and adding in the remaining characters. So now that it has been created, let's move to it. So current is going to be T. Length of products is less than 3. So we go ahead and append word to current.product. And now there are no more characters for us to loop through, so we are done and we can just return. And we're going to be doing this for every single word in product. So say we also have the word CB in our products, right? This is sorted, so this is going to be greater than this one over here. If we call add again with this, current again is going to be self.root. We loop through for character and word, so we start off at C. C actually is in our current children's dictionary, so this is not true. We can't go in this if condition. Instead, we're just going to move current down to be current.children of that character we're on. So current moves down to C over here. We make a check. Length of products is less than 3. We're going to append our word to product. So we're just adding CB over here. So if we were to type out C, we would output cat and CB as our list of the possible 3 words that we have. Going back in this for loop, the last character we have is a B. This is not in current.children, so we're going to go ahead and add it in. So we're creating a key in current.children's dictionary. It's going to be of this character B, and it's going to be its own try node, so it's going to have its own product list and its own children. The length of current.product is less than 3. It's empty right now, so we're going to go ahead and add CB to it. And we go back in this for loop. There's nothing for us to iterate over. So now this is our entire try data structure that we have so far. And now there are no more characters for us to iterate through. So we are done. So this is our entire try data structure built out so far. Honestly, the hardest part is actually building up this structure with the words that we want within it. Now, once we actually go through every single character in our search word, it's going to be very easy to figure out what to output. It's already in our structure, right? So now let's go ahead and type that out. Typing this part out, we know we want an output that is going to be a list of lists, so let's actually initialize that. Output is going to be an empty list for every character that we have in search word, so for character in search word. So we had gone ahead and sorted our products and built out our try data structure. Now we want to go through every single character in search word. So for I, character in enumerate search word. And if you are unfamiliar with what enumerate is, all it does is it lets us get the index as well as the actual character at that index. So say in our example, this was our products list and our search word is CT. So what are we going to do? We are going to start off with our very first character and we want to see if it exists in our structure. So for that, actually, we also want to define our current structure to be self.root that we had up here. So current is going to be self.root. Now we want to see if this character exists in current's children. If it does not, we can break right away, right? So say we were searching for the word DE, we would just break right away. D doesn't exist in our children's dictionary. So we're going to output the empty list. And same for that next character for DE, it also will not exist because D doesn't exist. So we're just going to be outputting the empty list, which we already have in output. So if the character doesn't exist in our children's dictionary, we're just going to stop and return output. So if character not in current.children, we will just break. And once we are out of this for loop, we're just going to return our output. So we're going to break out of this for loop and just return output. Now, what if the character does exist in our structure, right? If we're looking for CT, we start off with character C right over here. Well, that means we just want to go to that object. So current is now going to be current.children of that character that we are on. So if we're looking for C, current is going to be self.root. And our character does exist in current's children, right? So we're just going to set current to be current.children of that character. So current is over here now. And we're going to take what we have in this product list and just add this to our output. So output at index I is going to equal current.product instead of the empty list. So to output instead of the empty list, we now have cat and CB. If we were to type out the word C. So we go back in this for loop, move down to our next character. We see the character we are on is T, and character is not in current's children, right? This children's dictionary only has A and B, it doesn't have T. So we're going to break and we're going to return output, which is going to be CAT and CB for our first character, which is C, and nothing for that next character because there is no word in products with a prefix of CT. It's only CAT or CB. And that is it. We just wrote out everything we needed to write out. Actually, it should be products without an S. We have children, we have product, we're adding words to our structure, and then we're just searching for it. So let's go ahead and submit this. And it is accepted. Now we just did a full walkthrough of our function with a couple of examples, but if you have any questions whatsoever, of course, let me know down below. I'll answer all of them. And if this video was helpful, like, comment, share, and subscribe. It really supports the channel. And as always, I will see you in the next video.